Hi friends, greeting from Anamol Laboratories Private Limited. In a series of common errors in clinical chemistry, we will take LDH now. Before we go into the common errors, let us see how LDH reagent really works. Pyruvate, which is present in the reagent, and NADH also, which is present in the reagent, reacts with the LDH, which is present in the serum, giving you lactate and NAD. NADH has an absorbance at 340 nanometer. While the reaction progresses, NAD is formed. Hence, there is a constant decrease in absorbance at 340 nanometer. Kinetically, this is what we measure. At 340 nanometer, decrease in absorbance is a measure of LDH activity. Okay, now let's come down to what kind of errors we can have it in the LDH estimation. There are common errors which are categorized into three types. The type 1, which is the result oriented. The type 2 is reagent oriented. And the type 3 is program oriented. Now let's take them one by one. Results oriented again has four categories: low results or high results, results which are sometime low and sometime high, and results which are not as per the clinician's expectation. How do you take care of this area? Watch your factor. What is the factor? Factor basically, when you run a calibrator, the concentration of calibrator divided by the delta absorbance which you get while you run the test. This factor should remain more or less a constant figure. In your day-to-day assay, if the factor is constant, guarantee of the results is more or less accurate. To make even more sure, run a control serum along with it. A control serum is the one which has got a lot specific and methodology specific value mentioned by an independent organization. And if you find in your today's assay a control serum value falls close to the central value, that is mean value, or plus or minus 2 standard deviation, which is an acceptable range, your results are acceptable one. Second category which you fall is the reagent oriented. LDH reagent, although it's a two reagent system, but it's a transparent one. Any abnormal color which is noticed in the LDH reagent, any turbidity which is observed in the LDH reagent, or because of gross contamination, if any inactivity is noticed, that is no reaction with the serum, or else the fourth type is insufficient reagent. While you are using it, the last few mLs are getting sucked in the air. These kind of errors can be eliminated by visually observing this reagent in a test tube or a beaker, and if you find turbid or colored or anything abnormal, discard this reagent, replace it. The third category is program related. Now this is a kinetic chemistry. Important to keep it in mind is that its reaction time is controlled. Program has delay and the read time. These two figures are mentioned in the user manual or technical insert of the manufacturer. If the delay time is recommended 60 seconds, must ensure that you follow that. Read time can be little up and down here and there, but whatever it is, it further instrument calculates for delta OD per minute. So recommended is 60 seconds. Ensure that this is followed. Calibrator concentration is the next important area. Very commonly this is having an error. What is the error? Is that you have forgotten to change the calibrator concentration as per the new vial which you have. Previous calibrator value is fed into the program, factors are wrong, results are wrong. Ensure that your current value of the calibrator vial is into the program installed. Okay, now let's come down to the wavelength. Wavelength is 340 nanometer. Normally 340 nanometer is the wavelength or filter which deteriorates with the time when the instrument ages. ensure that your instrument has 340 nanometer wavelength, well calibrated and working fine in order to get your results all right. Next one is sample to reagent ratio. This sample to reagent ratio is mentioned in your technical insert, and you must ensure that for 1 ml, whatever is the volume recommended, 20 microliter or so, you ensure that you take that. Maximum what you can deviate is you can become the both the volumes half, that is reagent 0.5 ml and sample volume exactly half of what is recommended. If this is maintained, your results are going to be all right. Important is, whatever is the sample to reagent ratio for calibrator, the same should be for the sample. And if this is followed, there is a high possibility that your results are reportable ones. And the crux of the whole thing, always ensure that you watch your factor properly. If your factor is constant, there is a very high possibility of not having any error which is in your assay. Thank you very much for watching, and if you like it, subscribe by pressing the bell icon. Thank you.